It's Saturday night, and we're now heading back to the festival to go and pick up all the same stuff that was in the truck the other day. I've angled the camera on my head down a little bit, so hopefully it's capturing a bit, well, all of the windscreen and probably a little bit of the kind of the dashboard and everything. But we'll have to see what happens, because I don't really want to start adjusting my driving position just to kind of get a good camera angle, because that'd be a bit silly. But I'll try and make it as good as I can. I might knock the air on the seat down a notch or two, because I don't want to adjust it too much either, because I'm in it being in this hire truck. I'm only not going to be in this after Reading. I should have my truck back. So once I've got my truck back, which is the same as the other one, we've got two DAFs, I can properly adjust it then, and it should be kind of the same setting for both, if you know what I mean. I knew I wasn't going to make them lights. Shows wait here. There isn't a fucking red light. I look like a band bus. Alright, let's see how much of an ordeal this is going to be getting back on. I was only down here the other day, but I've forgotten how awful this bit of road is.
You have reached your destination on your right.
Could definitely do with a bit of repaving. Artist in production. Straight ahead. Oh yeah, here we go.
You have reached your destination.
Window down, because there will probably be a security guard here now. This is going to be great fun. Come on then, out you come. I'm hoping this is just going to be production, because there ain't nowhere for me to go. If punters start coming down here, which they, well, still, what time is it? 40 minutes till the end of the show. Thank you, kind sir. I just don't want to take this onto the grass, because I've got no idea how wet it is here. It's been drizzling up and down the country, so I'm not going to be off-roading it. Well, not on these bits anyway. I know the trackway down here is gravel and hard standing, but these bits on the side here I'm keeping well away from. Kind of liking, I was going to say, the lack of security, but there's a man in a high-vis just there. Evening.
Hey, Pat.
How you doing? I'm here to pick up all the sound gear.
All four.
ESS.
No problem. Do you know where you're going?
Yeah, I take it I can't get to the stage at the minute, so I'll just park alongside it or something
no
like
problem.
That. Yeah, cheers mate, thank you.
Cheers.
Nice friendly man. And it looks like there's a show still going on. Don't know if the camera will pick it up or not, but you might just catch the top of it. Me being the tall bastard that I am. Donk, 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 donk. Bloody hell, someone's bought a bus with them. It's a bit posh. lighting truck's still there. So I think for now, best bet for now, big crowd over there, there's not even anyone on. I think they're now about to put someone on. I wonder. You're right. Sorry?
Who's it for again?
ASS. It's all the sound gear. So we're, turn that rubbish off, Jeremy Vine, picking up stuff today for Reading Festival, just some bits and pieces, and there will be tomorrow as well. Thought I'd record this because it's a particularly tight reverse to get into this place. It's only a little warehouse. One of the guys who's up front in his car had come along just to see me back in because it's tight and there's sort of overhanging roofs and there's a garage around there as well and there's always cars in the way. So it's nice to have an extra pair of hands. Hopefully the camera angle is a little bit better now. Come on, traffic lights. Just keeping an eye on that left mirror because when I turn right, the back end of my truck, because I'm back in the DAF just to pick this stuff up, he hasn't noticed that his light's green. He's too busy playing with his phone. But yeah, the overhang on this tends to kick out a little bit, so after that white car, I'll let him come past. Happy days. See if anyone's blocking the yellow box. Not yet. Here comes the rain, right on cue. Bad today as it was last time. You have to keep quite close to them tyres and then kind of just as your back wheel goes past it, start turning. Just watching. Even all these cars are write-offs. Just watching the front end of the truck. easier doing this with a clutch. Back again in another vehicle. Close that. It's better. So, still out on pickups today. Tuesday. And because we're using both of the trucks as like a dry storage area for all the stuff that's ready to go to Reading and Leeds, I'm out today in our 7.5-ton panel van. It's an old V-Reg Mercedes Vario, and to be fair to it, it goes, you know, it runs well. It's a good workhorse, bit of a tank, but yeah, it's just old, as you can see. Used to be on analog, Taco, although that got decommissioned earlier this year. Now the digi one's just over there, which is quite irritating because you can't see how much driving time you got left. But yeah, that's it really. That's the only thing I've got to do today. I left the lock up at 9, went to the place to pick it up, got there at 11. It's now just gone 12 o'clock. And I should be back there. Sat-nav says 10 past 1, but I'm going to stop at Donington on the way and just grab a shower. So I'll probably be back by 1:30, and that's my day done really. And then I haven't got to do anything until 3 p.m. tomorrow, which is when we load the trucks properly for Reading, and then once they're loaded, go down. It's a lovely day, certainly better weather than at the weekend for that festival. Absolutely chucked it down while we were there. But yeah, nice easy day. No cruise control though, I do miss the cruise control. But I've been sort of cruising at about 90k. If I catch up to a truck, then I just ease off and follow it for a bit. Traffic's really light today, so. So just a nice steady day, really. Right, tubers. We're just around the corner from Reading Festival. Is about 20 to 9 as expected. Traffic in town is somewhat mental. Lots of people, lots of traffic. But we're nearly here. We've just got to get in now. Be the fun bit. I'm just going to take the road. And I want to go right here, I believe. Blue gate is what we want. And here's the famous Reading Strip, as I call it. It's not too bad now, but on the way out, it was just people walking everywhere in the road and whatever. But yeah, it's been a long old day. People playing with their phones, not paying attention, still got his indicator on. And I believe the entrance is just kind of at the end of the road up here on the right, where it was last year. They might have changed it. And then all these temporary shops pop up selling crates of beer and whatever else.
Cross the roundabout, second exit, reach the arrival, then you have reached your destination.
I think it's straight over this, is it? The blue? Yep.
Cross the roundabout, second exit.
It's alright, mate, don't worry about the fucking 20 ton truck that's coming towards you. I think this, where is it? It's not there. I'm going to guess it's all the same as last year. If so, it should be just up here where all the traffic is. Oh, now we sit in the traffic jam. All we want to do is get to where all those high-vis people are. Hey, alright, how you doing?
Where are you going?
Festival Republic.
Yeah.
Festival Republic.
Festival Republic. Right. Where are you going though? Yeah, come off
the road. The Festival Republic stage.
Festival Republic stage?
Yeah, yeah.
Video Nick David. Find out me as well, that company is. Video Nick David's
a channel 4. Come on, Nick David. What is it you've got?
Sound. I'm with.
Tell Cheddar he can't get hold of Nick Davis on the radio, but he's going to the Festival Republic stage. Once he gets up there, Cheddar can try him again.
Oh, absolute clusterfuck as usual.
All right, okay.
And we're in, it's as easy as that. No idea where I'm supposed to be stopping. I know where my stage is anyway, so I guess that's where I'll be heading. Ooh. Sorry? You're right, bud, how you doing?
Get your first public?
Yep.
That's fine. Next will be down there anyway.
Oh, right, okay, cool. It's just round there.
Right, this is for you, see? First of public.
Yeah. Yeah.
Did you send them down?
Cheers.
Lovely. Down,
yeah, yeah. Cheers, bud, thank you. Find the stage now. I think it's that big red tent just over there. Because these are the buses that the guys usually sleep on. This one on the left, I think. Fuck knows where I'm supposed to park. There for now. Anyway, get out of here first. Oh, that were a bit nasty. Don't know what that was. I'll have to move that bit of fence. Back's clear. I think the front might just spin it. Yes. Magic. In the morning, we should be back by, it says 20 past 6, but probably need to stop and get some fuel somewhere on the way, so might be around 6:45 kind of time. It's all done, everything's gone. Cheers, mate.
After 300 yards, cross the roundabout.
Surprisingly quiet along here, because last time I did the later one, and I was leaving at about 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. And this whole road and the pavement was just full of people. But yeah, a fairly successful, successful weekend at Reading Festival. No problems, everyone was happy. All the bands that we were dealing with ran smoothly. All the comedians went really well. Yeah, it was just a good fun. Hard work, long hours, but good fun. That's all that really matters. So now we've just got to get out of Reading, which is going to be a nightmare, because there's going to be loads of pedestrian traffic and production traffic, trucks and buses and taxis and all sorts. But you know, it takes as long as it takes. saying that, it doesn't actually look too bad. Wonder whether it's a little bit early for people to be leaving. Busy in there. Bank holiday weekend, and here I am driving at 3 o'clock in the morning. Lift. Lifted the lights. It's dead, can't believe it. Last year I was crawling along here at about 5 miles an hour. Although this road is a bit naff. Lots of sharp corners, and it's very steep. And coming down, you're ragging the engine brake the whole way. And then coming up, you're having to do things like this. Come on, mate, you get a fucking bus through there. Thank you. Come again. Come on, lorry. Will it change gear on the hill? I hope not. I don't know, it's going into blue. Why hasn't it changed? There we go. And it lost all its momentum. No, it's doing alright, actually. So yeah, so I get back, let's say 7 o'clock this morning. Then 3 p.m. we're unloading both our trucks. There's an Arctic coming in that was at Leeds Festival, and that's going to get unloaded at midday. Once that's done, I've then got to jump into a van, just a transit, and take a load of stuff, hire stuff back to a place in North Allerton, and then that will be me done for the day. And then I think at 7 o'clock Tuesday morning I start, and it'll be in this truck taking a load of hire stuff back to two different places, and then taking this lorry back because my one's actually been fixed. It's got two new barn doors on it at last. It's only taken about a month, so we're going to take this back to the hire place, go and pick my truck up, and then that's it really for a couple of weeks. So I suspect this might be the last vlog that I do for a little while. I can't remember when my next job is. I think it's like late September. I've actually got some time off, which I'm looking forward to, like proper time off. I'll probably end up doing some agency work because I tend to get itchy feet after a few days, but just a shame I've missed the bank holiday weekend, really. It would have been nice to have that off, but hey ho. I thought I was going to end it there because I forgot that I actually had a fair bit of driving to do today. Come on, gearbox, find a gear. I've got to drop, I saved a lorry load of stuff off. You could, the size of the boxes that I've got, you could probably fit them in a transit, but it's just the weight because they're all like amp racks and fairly kind of heavy bits of gear. So we're going to take them in this just to be safe. And that's going to a place in Redditch, kind of Birmingham way. So it says about an hour 45 to get there, but that's with, I think it says about 5 minutes traffic. But yeah, it's too much daytime driving for me during the summer. I think Segan's pointed out that something will go wrong with me soon if I see this much daylight, because obviously usually I'm chucking around at 2 or 3 in the morning. But yeah, I thought as well I'd do, because this is the last day we'll have this Scania, because we're taking this back once I've done this drop in Redditch. And I thought I'd do a little kind of quick review. It's not going to be very in depth, mainly because I'm not sure how much battery life I've got left on the camera. But I'll just sort of gloss over a few good points and a few bad points. Good points, I like the dash layout. I think there's kind of the wraparound thing, everything's within reaching distance, whereas the DAF, you've got buttons like all the way over in the middle, which are really hard to get to. I think the gear, you know, selector, drive, reverse is in a good place. It's got a proper horn. The handbrake's in a good place. It's got a fridge, which is nice. I've been making good use of that. The cab's actually quite tall, you know, like for a rigid compared to our DAF. So I think it's definitely a little bit taller than our usual trucks, which has been quite handy while I've been virtually living in it at Reading Festival. The night heat is great. Cruise control's great. I haven't really played much with all of the adaptive cruise control and collision detection nonsense, but I guess it's a good thing that it's there. Just wait and see if anyone tries to cut in front of me. Not today. But yeah, just kind of in general, quite a pleasant truck to drive. It might be a little bit kind of different on the camera because of the way that the mic is set up to hear me, not the engine. But it is pretty quiet in the cab compared to the DAF that we drive. You know, it's nice and smooth. And, you know, the ride's good, the seat's comfortable, which I see quite a few people online complaining about Scania seats, but I've actually found this seat a lot more comfortable than the ones in our trucks. And, yeah, that's kind of most of the good points, really. I mean, if anyone's got any questions about it, do leave a comment, you know, in the comment box down at the bottom, and I'll do my best to answer it. I'm sure there's things that I'm totally forgetting about. But yeah, but a few kind of bad points really. I mean, the cruise control's great, but there's no downhill or rolling kind of control on it. I think I said, might have been in a previous clip that will be in this video, or maybe even in the last video, that there's no way, like on the DAF when you've got the automatic engine brake, there's no way for it to control its speed. And you do quite often find yourself suddenly, you know, pushing 60 down a hill. I guess on the opposite of that, the engine brake is good when you use it, but the button is in such an awkward place, like right in the middle of the steering column on the floor, that it's just like not very natural to use it. If they put it where the clutch pedal would have been, because there's nothing there, that would have made loads more sense to me. Which is, I don't know, it's just quite strange really. But yeah, it's got air suspension on it, which I was going to show you on the computer, but the light's just gone green, which you can adjust using the button down here. But there's no like button to level it out, which is quite odd. So if I've ever adjusted it, like to match the height of the truck to a loading dock or whatever, there's no button to automatically rise it up again, so I found myself having to play with up and down and look at the screen on the computer until it kind of looks level, which doesn't really sound very good to me. But then sometimes I've got in it and it readjusts itself, but then sometimes it doesn't. It's just a bit kind of hit or miss really. But I think my biggest complaint, well, one other thing actually, is the visibility. The mirrors are the opposite way around to the DAF in the wide angle ones on top, whereas on the DAF they're on the bottom, which makes loads more sense because you want that wide angle down the bottom so that you could see anyone that's, you know, poking right down beside either of your doors. Whereas when it's on top, all I seem to get is a really good view of the sky and the other side of the road, which is just kind of a bit pointless really. And the mirrors on it are huge. They do seem to kind of block quite a lot of your view when you're coming up to a roundabout. But I've really found myself, it might have come out in some of the clips, you really have to kind of move around like this to kind of see past them. And the front corner mirror doesn't really seem to give as much visibility as the one on the DAF either. It doesn't actually catch that front corner, which is a bit pointless. But yeah, but my biggest complaint is actually the bunk. I've found that to be the most uncomfortable bed that I've ever slept in, like out of any truck or hotel room or hostel or, you know, air mattress, camping beds, and even like, you know, my mattress at home or if I stayed at a friend's house or whatever. Bed in this Scania is the most uncomfortable thing I've ever slept on. It's too narrow for a start. For me to be able to lay down flat, I can't fit in it shoulder to shoulder. I have to move the driver's seat forward towards the steering wheel to be able to kind of lay down properly, which is crap because you want to be leaving your seat in your driving position if you can. It's you don't want to keep having to move it back and forward every day just so you can fit into bed. But yeah, it's just generally really, really, really uncomfortable. I've actually had a really bad back the last two or three days, like kind of lower back pain, which I've been taking painkillers for. And last night, because I stayed at the lockup, my boss booked me into the Travelodge, which is only around the corner. And one night in there, sleeping in a proper bed, has pretty much sorted my back out. So, yeah. 0 out of 10 for that Scania. And that remote you might have caught there, see it with the wire? That's for the night heater, and I think you can use it to set an alarm and stuff like that. And it's positioned in such a stupid place. It goes on a little clip, which is right next to kind of where, sort of, I don't know, like your elbows are if you're laying down flat. So every time you move in bed, you knock it off, and then it just gets caught up with you in bed, and you end up turning on the heater or turning it off or doing something else with it. And so I've resorted to just kind of hanging it off of one of the coat pegs. But yeah, but I think it's quite important for a truck to have a comfortable bed, considering that you need to be getting good rest in it. Really unimpressed with that, which is a shame, because you know, it's a 65 plate Scania. I was expecting kind of the best of the best of the best kind of a deal. Oh, I can't quite squeeze through, it's a shame. But I think if I'd bought one of these, you know, out of my own money, or if the company I worked for had bought one, I'd be pretty disappointed in what you're getting for your money.
Take the exit, M1, then.
Because, you know, as a truck, it does go well and it pulls well, and, you know, mechanically it's sound, but it just doesn't seem like they've actually consulted a driver to figure out if it's good for living in. Because, again, it sounds really stupid, but there are no cup holders in this truck. It's just, you know, every car, van, lorry for the last however many years has had cup holders in it, and they just seem to have totally glossed over that. And I mean, what do us truck drivers do while we're driving? You know, drink coffee or tea, you know, or water or something. You know, when you're driving 9 hours a day, you're going to be wanting to drink something. I just find it bizarre that they've not bothered to put cup holders in. So yeah, it just doesn't seem like they've put a driver in it. You know, they've made a prototype, they put a driver in it, and he would have probably immediately pointed out that there was no cup holder in it. Just say thank you to that driver behind. Probably would have pointed out that the bed is horrible. And it's really odd because the bed's really, really wide in the middle, right, where the fridge is, and the bit on top. But unless you've got an absolutely massive ass, it's just like, what's the point? It's it's just strange. So yeah, that's my little kind of a moan about the truck. But it's almost kind of related to, like, people may or may not have seen that Scania unveiled their new truck a few days ago. And loads of people online are saying that it's just a horrible looking truck. It doesn't look very practical for everyday use, etc. And I don't know, you know, I thought Scania was supposed to be like the leading truck manufacturer, but personally, I'd much prefer the DAFs that we've got. I think they're far superior to live in. Not necessarily as good going. This one is definitely more powerful. On this hill here, it's kind of holding its speed really, really well. I mean, I am pretty much unfreighted. But in the DAF now, even unfreighted, I'd have had to have knocked it down a gear. And it'd be kind of struggling to hold at that speed. So, yeah, I don't know. I'd probably just... pretty average. I'd give it a 5 out of 10, personally, this truck. I'd certainly not worth what I imagine is quite a large price tag that comes with it anyway. Remember that part where I said there was traffic on the M1? Here it is. Time is at 7:30. And it's Tuesday today, the day after the bank holiday, so everyone's back to work. Well, apart from the people that are put in the city, but so I suspect this is probably just normal traffic, although it says 7.5 minutes I'm going to be stuck in this now. Great.